Good morning, students. How are you all? So we were doing chapter 7, triangle and its properties. Today we are going to start new exercise 7.2. So the first question is, which of the following lengths can be the side of the triangle? So we have studied side property of the triangles. So what was the property? That the sum of two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. So if we are given 2 cm, 2 cm, and 2 cm, we have to show whether the this line segments will form a triangle or not. So 2 + 2, it is greater than 2. So then will be the sides of triangle, will be the sides of triangle. Okay, your second question is asked that 3 cm, 4 cm, and 5 cm. Now 3 cm + 4 cm, it is 7, which is greater than 5 cm. So will be sides of triangle. Okay, understood? Now next, third one. 8 cm, 12 cm, and 20 cm. Okay, so 8 + 12 is equal to 20, not greater than 20. So will not be sides of triangle. So in this way, by the side property of the triangle, we can find out whether the given line segments will form a triangle or not. Now next question is, in triangle ABC, if angle A is 40 degree, angle C 50 degree, which of the following is true? So, first one is, we will make a right angle. We will make a triangle first. A, B and C. And it is asked that this is 40 degree and we are asked this is 50 degree. So, 40 plus 50 is what? 90 degree. And the sum total of the triangle is, angle sum property is, that sum of all three angles in the triangle should be 180 degree. So, this 40 plus 50 is 90 degree. So, the third angle will be what? 90 degree. So, we can draw this A, B, C. 40 degree, 50 degree, and this is 90 degree. Okay? So, the thing which will be true will be AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Okay, it is true because this is right angle triangle, so Pythagoras theorem will be proved here. In triangle ABC, next question. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. Angle ACB is 70 degree and angle ADE is 55 degree. We have to find. Let's make the diagram first. A, B, C. Okay, here DE is parallel to AB, BC. So here, and we are given this ADE as 55 degree. Okay, and we are asked this angle, this one, and this angle. Okay, so first of all, what we will do? In triangle, we will consider this whole triangle. In triangle ABC, this is 55 degree, ADE is 55 degree. So ABC will be also 55 degree. Why? Because they are corresponding angles. So angle ADE is equal to angle ABC is equal to 55 degree because they are corresponding angles. Then this we got as 55 degree. Okay. Now this is 55 degree. Angle BAC will be what? Angle angle BAC will be 180 degree minus 55 degree plus 70 degree. Why 70 degree? Okay, this 70 C we are given 70 degree, that's why. So in the triangle ABC, 55 degree is given, 70 degree is given. We can find out angle BAC. So angle BAC plus angle ABC plus angle ACB is equal to 180 degree. So BAC we don't know. ABC is 55 degree. ACB is what? 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. So BAC will be what? 55 plus 70. We will minus it from 180. Okay. So angle BAC you will get 55 degree. Okay. So this angle we got 55 degree. Now if we will consider triangle ADE, in triangle ADE, okay, this is 55 degree, this is 55 degree. So by angle sum property, angle ABAE plus angle ADE plus angle AEB is equal to 180 degree. Angle DAE is what? DAE, we don't know the okay, this is 55 degree plus 55 degree plus AED is equal to 180 degree. 55 plus 55 will give you 110. Okay, 110 degree is plus AED is equal to 180 degree. So angle AED is equal to 180 minus 110, that will be 70 degree. So this we will get 70 degree. So in this way, we have found out all the angles which we are asked in the question. Now let's move on to the next question. Now in the next question, find the values of x and y in the figure. I have made the figure. We have to find the value of x and y. First of all, it is given that angle CBD is 130 degree. So angle ABC plus angle CBD is equal to 180 degree because they are linear pairs. Okay, they are linear pairs. So ABC will be what? ABC will be what? This we are having 130 degree is equal to 180 degree. So angle ABC will be 50 degree. 180 minus 130, that is 50 degree. So this we got 50 degree. Now it is given that AB is equal to AC. So angle B is equal to angle C. So it will be 50 degree. Okay. Now by angle sum property in triangle ABC, angle A plus angle B plus angle C will be 180 degree. We are knowing angle B as 50 degree. We are knowing angle C as 50 degree. We will subtract it from 180. So angle A will got as 80 degree. So this X is equal to 80 degree is equal to X. So here we got the value of X and C is 50 degree. Now we have to find the value of Y. As you can see, angle ACB and angle ACE are linear pairs. So angle ACB plus angle ACE is equal to 180 degree because they are linear pair. So angle ACB is what? We don't know. Okay, ACB we know, that is 50 degree. Y we don't know, that is ACE is equal to 180 degree. So angle Y will be what? 130 degree. So here Y also we got as 130 degree. Now next question is, in triangle PQR, we are given that R is 90 degree and PR is equal to QR. It is given to us. We have to find the value of X and Y. So first let me make the Okay, here we are having 90 degree. P, R, Q. Okay, this is X, this is X, and these line segments are equal. PR is equal to QR, and here it is Y. We have to find the value of X and Y. So first of all, angle, what will be the angle P? It will be equal to angle Q. The both will be X. Okay, here it is given that angle R is 90 degree. So by angle sum property in triangle PQR, angle P plus angle Q plus angle R will be 180 degree. This is X, Q is also X, angle R is 90 degree, is equal to 180 degree. So 2X plus 90 degree is equal to 180 degree. So 2X is equal to 90 degree. So X is 45 degree. Both the angles are equal, so X here also 45 degree and here also 45 degree. Now we have to find the value of Y. So here, as you can see, angle X plus Y is equal to 180 degree because they are not linear pairs. As they are linear pairs, their sum total will be 180 degree. So X we know as 45 degree, Y we don't know. So Y will be 180 minus 45 degree, and it will be what? 180 minus 45, 135 degree. So in this way we got the value of Y as 135 degree. Now let's move on to some more questions. Now in the next question, let me read the question for you. In the figure, PQR is an isosceles triangle. Find the values of S and D. Okay, we have to find S and T here, and this is an isosceles triangle because two sides PR and PQ are equal. Okay, as you can see, we are given 80 degree angle. This angle will be 80 degree because they are vertically opposite angles. So this we got as 80 degree. Now, as you know that these angles will be also equal because the line segments opposite them are also equal. So A by angle sum property, triangle PQR, angle P plus angle Q plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. Angle P is 80 degree. This we can take X plus X is equal to 180. So 2X is equal to 180 minus 80. So 2X is equal to 100. So X is 50 degree. Means your this angle Q is 50 degree and your angle R will be also 50 degree. Here we got this 80, 50 and 50. Now we have to find out angle. Okay, so here we can find out angle S. How? Because they are linear pairs. So angle PRQ plus angle PRM. Here it is M. PRM is equal to 180 degree because they are linear pair. So here PRQ, that is 50 degree plus PRM is equal to 180. So PRM angle will be 180 minus 50, that is 130 degree. So this we will get as 130 degree. Okay, now angle, here also we can take as linear pairs because 80 degree plus angle T is equal to 180 degree because they are linear pairs. So 80 angle T will be what? 180 minus 80, and angle T will be 100 degree. So here also we got a 100 degree. So in this way we got the value of S and T. Okay. Now let's move on to the next question. Find the value of X, Y and Z from the figure. Okay. Let me draw the figure. So here in the figure, we are given that we have to find the value of X, Y and Z, and we are given that AP line segment is equal to BC line segment and AP line segment is equal to CD line segment. Now, as AP line segment and BC line segment segment. So angle CAD, CAD is equal to 30 degree. Okay. This we are given as, okay, 30 degree. Then angle CAD plus angle ACD, CAD plus angle ACD is plus Z is equal to 180 degree by angle sum property. CAD is 30 degree plus this also 30 degree because both the line segments are equal. So 30 degree plus 30 degree plus Z is equal to 180 degree. So Z will be what? 180 minus 30 plus 30, 60 minus 60 degree. So Z is equal to 120 degree. So here we got the value of Z as 120 degree. Hopefully you have understood exercise 7.2. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Till then, take care, goodbye and thank you.